This is video 3. In this video, we are going to learn few words from the story Wake Up Pali. We are going to know their meaning as well as how they can be used in various sentences. Remember one thing, these words are to be read as whole words.
Let's learn list 1 vocabulary words from the story Wake Up Pali. Up. Please repeat after me. The word is up. And up refers to a position which is located to a higher place. You can see the boy, he is looking up. And I have used it in a sentence like the boy is looking up. Let's move on to the next slide. The word is but. But means other than. You can see this man, he is saying that he is a teacher. So, I have used it in a sentence like, I am not a doctor, but a teacher. Let's move on to the next slide. The word is not. Please repeat after me. The word is not. And not is a form of no. You can see the boy, he is writing something. Can you see this? But do you think the page is completed? No. So, the boy is saying, I have not completed my work. Let's move on to the next slide. The word is do. Please repeat after me. The word is do. You can see the boy is crying and mother is saying something to the boy. So what is she saying? She is saying do not cry. So the sentence I have used it here. Do not cry. Let us move on to the next slide. The word is no. Please repeat after me. The word is no. And no means not any. The sentence I have used this word in. Should we eat junk food? What will be your answer? The answer is no. Let's move on to the next slide. The word is now. What is the word? The word is now. Now means at the present time. And I have used this word in a sentence like the boy is eating now. You can see the boy eating. So presently he is eating. Let's move on to the next slide. The word is she. Repeat after me. The word is she. And she usually refers to a girl. Right? You can see the girl here. So I have used this word she in a sentence like she is a girl. Let's move on to the next slide. The word is on. Please repeat after me. The word is on. Here it refers to a particular day. Can you see the girl and the park? So the girl is saying something. So let's see. Let's hear what the girl is saying. She's saying, I go to the park on every Sunday. You can read this word on in this sentence. Let's move on to the next slide. For. Please repeat after me. The word is for. This girl is saying something. Let us go for a walk. So, the word for means a place someone is going to or some kind of work which is to be done. So I have used this word for in a sentence like let us go for a walk. Let's move on to the next slide. The word is yes. Repeat after me. The word is yes. And We can use it in a sentence like, should we eat healthy food? What will be your answer? Your answer will be yes. Yes refers to a positive answer, which we use when we answer a question. Please repeat these words. Try to use these words in your daily conversation sentences.
So what all we have done in today's class? We have read the story. We have used our pointer finger for the same. I have asked you to complete the sentences. You all have done it. I know that very well. Other than that, we have learned few words from the story, Wake Up Pari. We have learned their meanings also, as well as how they can be used in various sentences. I hope you all have liked the story. And one thing I want from you, I want you all to read the story as and when you get time. Till then, bye-bye, see you.